When you're ready, sit in the driver's seat. To get the loco started, set the battery isolation switch to the closed position. To activate the control desk, set the master key into the on position. Set the reverser into the engine only position. The locomotive is now ready to be started. Push the engine start button on. To release the air pressure holding the wheels, set the driver's brake to the running position. With the locomotive running, to get going, set the reverser to the forward position. To make others aware that this loco is operational, switch the headlights on. Turn the parking brake handle to release it. Finally, to get going, set the throttle to at least 20%. Well done, the loco is on the move. To bring the locomotive to a gentle stop, set the driver's brake to the initial application position. Take this basic training and apply it to further operations, and you'll do great. This is a Class 47 diesel-electric locomotive in British Rail green livery. This tutorial will go through the start and stop procedure. Climb aboard to get going. Enter the cab through the door indicated. When you're ready, sit in the driver's seat. To get the loco started, set the battery isolation. To activate the control desk, set the master key into the on position. Set the reverser into the engine only position. The locomotive is now ready to be started. Push the engine start button on. To release the air pressure holding the wheels, set the driver's brake to the running position. With the locomotive running, to get going, set the reverser to the forward position. To make others aware that this loco is operational, turn the parking brake handle to release it. Finally, to get going, set the throttle. Well done, the loco is on the move. To maintain. To bring the locomotive to a gentle stop, set the driver's brake to the initial application position. Take this basic training and apply it to further operations, and you'll do great. Thank you.
You can pause the experience at any point and review pre... A heads-up display has appeared on the right side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed. The red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed. This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power control is in. These are brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems, allowing independent management of them. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. The Laramie subdivision runs for 60 miles between Cheyenne and Laramie, Wyoming, and delivers heavy freight over the 2,000-foot climb to the summit of Sherman Hill. This locomotive is an EMD SD70 ACE diesel locomotive and is rated at 4,300 horsepower. TrainSim World 2 allows you to ride and drive from a selection of camera views. Let's take a look now while exploring this train. You've only explored a small area here. So let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Sherman Hill, Wyoming. Here you can experience challenging grades, heavy freight, and iconic motive power in the heart of Union Pacific Territory. Along the way, be sure to uncover fossils, repair broken snow fences, install safety signs, and put up jackalope warnings. Conquer the continental divide and keep America thriving. Welcome to TrainSim World 2, Sherman Hill, Cheyenne to Laramie. Welcome to driver training. Today you'll be taken through the operation of this SD70 ACE in Union Pacific livery. During this brief introduction, we will go through the startup of the locomotive and freight operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. Take a seat in the engineer's. Firstly, we'll need to start the engine. In order to start the engine, the isolation switch will need to be set to start. The control and fuel pump button allows control of the fuel pumps from this cap. Press and hold the engine start button. Now we can set the isolation switch to run. The generator field, engine run, and control and fuel pump buttons will need to be activated in the lead locomotive. The engine run button allows control. We will now need to configure the brakes for the type of operations that we will be performing. The engine is now running, and we can depart. Set the switch as indicated. We'll need to set the lights for correct operation. The reverser determines the direction of travel. let's shut down this cab and head to the one in the lead unit. Climb down and make your way to the lead loco. Now we will need to set up this loco for operation. Set the switch as indicated. The reverser determines the direction of travel. Great work. That concludes the basics of operating this locomotive. Welcome to driver training. Today you'll be learning how to perform hill starts and also switch to dynamic brakes when descending. You will need to configure the lead locomotive each time you take over. To stop the formation rolling backwards, we will need to apply the throttle while the brakes are still applied. If you apply power too quickly, the wheels will slip. Now, slowly release the brake. If you are struggling for grip, apply sand to increase traction. Congratulations! You have reached the summit of Sherman Hill. As we start our descent, we'll need to switch to dynamic brakes to control our speed. Dynamic brakes allow the locomotives to control their speed while going downhill without causing excessive wear. Well done. That concludes today's training.
Welcome to this Talon II articulated electric multiple unit built by Bombardier Transportation. This is a three-car variant delivered to the S-Bahn Mitteldeutschland network in 2013. During this brief introduction, we will cover how to start up the unit for operation, get moving, and then how to bring the unit to a stop. To start with, climb aboard via the cab door and sit in the driver's seat. During normal operation, this unit draws electricity from the overhead catenary via a pantograph. However, since the pantograph is currently in the down position, we have to power the initial. With power available, use the master key to unlock the control desk and turn on the multifunction displays. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. Thank you. Move the power brake handle as required, and the train will begin to accelerate. Great work. The unit is now moving. Before traveling too far, let's bring the train to a halt. And to do this, move the power brake handle as required.
Welcome to this BR182 electric locomotive in DB Traffic Red livery. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the startup, stopping, and passenger door operations. Climb aboard to get started. The battery will power up the control desk and allow you to interact with it. This locomotive draws power from the overhead electrical supply via a contact arm mounted on the roof. For this to work, we'll need to set up and then raise the pantograph. It's important to use the correct light configuration when the train is operational. A lot of your time will be spent in the driver's seat. To get the locomotive up and running, set the master switch. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. The locomotive is now ready to be energized. This is control. Headlights are important in letting others around know that a locomotive is operational. We now need to wait a moment and let the brake system charge. It'll take a minute or two. When stopped for longer periods of time, or when leaving the cab, a parking brake is engaged. We'll need to use the master switch to determine the direction of travel. Give a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe, and then unlock the doors. Boarding is now complete. The train brake is used for normal line operations. Due to the size and weight of this train, small amounts of traction should be used to overcome initial friction and prevent overpowering the electrical systems. Now we're rolling, we can apply more power, and focus can be diverted towards achieving a desired speed. Coasting is a method used to easily... There's a short distance between here and your next stop, so be sure to manage the train and prevent overspeeding. Thank you. We're on final approach to Dessau, and we'll soon need to start applying a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable stop. Like before, unlock the doors to allow passenger boarding to commence. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.